500,000 people and their families lost their lives that fateful day in Haiti. Be Like Bread is designed as the letter B. It's 19,000 square feet. It has two open courtyards. It has 48,000 pounds of rebar alone in the footing, 700 yards of concrete. It will house 33 boys and 33 girls, symbolic of the 33 days that our daughter was buried in the rubble at the Hotel Montana. There will be six missionary rooms that we call missionary rooms, and we invite everybody in this room next year to come on down for a stay. It will have a community room in the middle of those missionary rooms that will house eight columns, significant and symbolic of the eight who lived from Lynn University, because we need to honor what they had done. They were able to walk away from the Hotel Montana and try to live every day of their life without guilt. The biggest thing I believe we're doing is building a survivable orphanage. Our orphanage starts right with the block. Pastor Lex has a block making factory that we make 1,000 to 1,200 blocks a day. The mixture is set up by SG&H in Boston. The structure of the block is strong enough to withstand the earthquake, and we start right there. And then we move into the same seismic standards as San Francisco. So this building will withstand the next earthquake. And we have had three small peaky-peaky earthquakes since I've been here. So they are there. The building will be sustainable. It's also, we had to dig five wells to get water for one orphanage. On the fifth well, we hit 10 gallons per minute. It will have nanotechnology to clean the filter the water, which not only we will give to the community, will be the water for our orphanage, and we will also have solar panels on the roof, because as you all know, electricity is a real value in Haiti, and sometimes you have it and sometimes you don't. That's for sustainability. The other most incredible piece is a group of doctors and nurses who reached out to us. And their organization is called Child in Hand, and they're the other table of blanc sitting next to us. This clinic is five rooms, 1,150 square feet, and I just can't tell you what they are taking on. It's incredible. Dr. Greg Ciatone and his wife, Amalia, will you please stand for one moment so people can see you? Greg is a professor at Harvard University, a world-renowned author, and also a disaster relief specialist, was one of the first federal teams on 9/11, and he is committed to, as Amalia is, to staffing that orphanage with both doctors and a machine that is right out of Star Wars, which is called remote medicine, that every president since Bush Sr. has had. And so we will be bringing the best medical care to the community of Grand Guam. Speaking of children, children are the most important component and the hardest work of the orphanage. And we know that's where the real work begins. My sister Chris, who is a child psychologist, along with my wife and three others, are in charge of the program committee and are working diligently to make sure that these children can grow, learn, and thrive in a safe environment. And that is truly what our mission is at Be Like Brit. We are building a school with Lex and Renee. Mission of Hope School will also serve the general public and be sustainable. We feel very blessed and honored to be partnered with Mission of Hope. Lastly, I want to thank my sister-in-law Jody, who is here, who has been the keeper of the gate for Be Like Brit. And I'd like to share a story with you about greater power. And the greater power is there are 4,600 universities and colleges in the United States of America. There are 2.5 million freshmen that enter those colleges each year. I'd like to ask everyone in this room, what are the odds that the president of Haiti's son would choose Boston as a place to go to college? What are the odds that that president's son, T. Mickey, would choose Suffolk University? What are the odds that our son, who is a sophomore, lost his roommate over the summer, lost his scholarship, so our son needed a new roommate? And what are the odds that when my son showed up to school Labor Day weekend, his roommate was one Michelle Martelly Jr.? So,
that's amazing.
In closing, I want to thank all of you for listening to us, for supporting us, and being part of our journey. With faith, hope, and love, faith in God, hope that someday we will spend an eternity with our daughter, love of family, love of community, love of the Haitian community, and love of country. Thank you. God bless you.